Don't leave your data unencrypted. It can get stolen.
Hello everyone, it's our Rich Linux user, and I am back with a new video on how to encrypt your hard drive in Linux. Using this method, you can encrypt a separate partition, a whole hard drive, or just USB stick. Let's get started. There are many methods to perform encryption in Linux. In this video, I will show you the method which I personally use the most. I believe it is a simple and reliable way to protect your data. It is based on lux and dm-crypt. If you already use encryption, what encryption method do you use? Please comment below. First, you need to install cryptsetup. Next, make sure the partition you are going to encrypt doesn't have any important data on it, because it will be overwritten during the encryption process. If your hard drive is brand new, you may need to create a new partition table. If you want to encrypt only part of your hard drive, you also need to repartition your hard drive into two partitions. One will be encrypted and another one won't. To manipulate the partitions on your system, you can use, for example, gparted. You can select your device here. As you can see, I don't have any partition table on this device. So I go to device, create new partition table, you keep it MS-DOS, and you create new partition table. Next, you need to add a partition here. So I click new, and I select to partition it as just one partition, so the whole drive will contain just one partition. If you want to have several partitions, you can also create several partitions by playing with the size. For example, you can change it here, whatever size you want, but I want it to be one partition for the whole drive. And you can also give it a name, Encrypt, for example. And you create it. After that, you just need to click apply and all the changes will be applied. Yes, you are sure that you will lose the data if you have any. So everything worked, and now as you can see, I have the partition which is called SDB1. You can also find out the name of your partition with the command lsblk and find the partition you need based on its size. For example, in my case, the partition name is SDB1. When the partition you want to encrypt is ready and all the data is backed up into another hard drive, run this command, where dev SDB1 is the partition you want to encrypt. Confirm that you agree to overwrite all the data in this partition, because you already backed up all the important data, if you had any. Next, you will be prompted to type your passphrase. When you type it, you will see nothing. This is normal and due to security reasons. You will need this password to unencrypt the partition. Make sure you memorize it. Next, open the encrypted partition. This is where you need to type your passphrase. Once the partition is opened, the encrypted partition is mapped to dev mapper SDB. Create a new file system on it. I recommend using XT4. I also suggest here to get rid of the reserved space. XT4 file system reserves some space by default, but you won't need it if you don't run your system on this partition. This way you also get more space on the drive. Now your partition is encrypted and ready to use. Mount it somewhere on your system. MNT is the most common place to mount partitions. Let's create a folder encrypted in it and perform the mounting. And start placing your files into it. Let's create a test file. I use sudo here because you need root permission to access the encrypted partition. Of course, you can change the permission with this command. And create another file without sudo. As you can see, there are two files in encrypted partition. You can also access it from your file manager. Here are the two files. When you are done working with encrypted partition, unmount it and close the map device. Now it is safe to disconnect the hard drive from your system. Next time, when you want to use your encrypted drive, connect your drive to the system and check its name. It is SDB in my case. Open the encrypted partition and mount it. Now it is available at mnt encrypted. As you can see, here's our newly created test files. And when you finished, unmount it and close. In some Linux system, such as Linux Mint in my case, you can also mount the encrypted partition by clicking on it and entering your passphrase. This way, you can encrypt any hard drive, including flash drives. If you encrypt a hard drive that is permanently connected to your system, you can also make it mount automatically during the boot of your system. But this is a topic for another video. Later, I will also show you how to encrypt your hard drives with a graphical interface, if the command line is not your favorite way to operate the system. Thank you for watching!